لقد كان في قصصهم عبرة لأولي الألباب ما كان حديثا يفترى ولكن تصديق الذي بين يديه وتفصيل كل شيء وهدى ورحمة لقوم يؤمنون.
الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. Brothers and sisters, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. It's me, Hisham, and I've got with me Brother Tariq. Assalamu alaikum, Brother Tariq.
Alaikum assalam wa rahmatullah. I'm so excited.
Why, bro?
Today is an amazing episode, as they all are.
Mashallah.
But we're in for a unique treat today, alhamdulillah.
Alhamdulillah.
So, assalamu alaikum, Sheikh Saeed. How are you?
Wa alaikum assalam. May Allah bless you, reward you, Tariq and Hisham.
Assalamu alaikum.
I'm also happy today because we'll talk about a unique ending, inshallah ta'ala.
Alhamdulillah. And of course, for those people that don't know, today's story is about Yunus alayhi wa salatu wa salam. Alhamdulillah. So, Sheikh, let's begin, inshallah, this session. Please tell us, what is this unique feature about the story of Yunus alayhi wa salatu wa salam?
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen, Allahumma salli ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran spoke about the people of Yunus alayhi salam, and he mentioned that they are the only ones that whom their faith and their belief in Allah ta'ala benefited them, subhanallah ta'ala, and saved them from Allah's punishment.
Subhanallah.
So it is a very good ending. About 100,000 people believed in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah ta'ala gave them the enjoyment in this life and the reward in this life.
SubhanAllah.
And Allah ta'ala saved them from his punishment.
SubhanAllah, Sheikh, and this is totally against the kind of the thing that we've been having,
Allahumma
which is that people are punished at the end for going against the commandment of Allah.
This is a unique thing about Yunus alayhi salam. Although Yunus alayhi salam got frustrated from them and was very angry of them, and he left them. Allah Ta'ala in the Quran said, فَلَوْلَا كَانَتْ قَرْيَةٌ آمَنَتْ فَنَفَعَهَا إِيمَانُهَا إِلَّا قَوْمَ يُونُسَ لَمَّا آمَنُوا كَشَفْنَا عَنْهُمْ عَذَابَ الْخِزِي فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا. There are no village whom people have believed in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and their belief benefited them except the people of Yunus alayhi salam, who believed in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and their faith and belief was availing them. And then Allah ta'ala said, وَمَتَّعْنَاهُمْ إِلَىٰ حِينٍ, and we let them to enjoy for a while.
SubhanAllah.
It's amazing.
So from this, Sheikh, is it fair to say that if we as an ummah today were to really truly believe in Allah, in his message, that we might too be saved from some calamity, as opposed to be transgressors and sinning and moving away from Allah's message?
Not that only, Tariq. If you believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if you seek forgiveness from him, if you return back to him, Allah ta'ala will give us a happy life.
SubhanAllah.
A nice life.
So it doesn't have to be always sacrifices and hardship.
No. Allah ta'ala in the Quran said on the tongue of Hud alayhi salam, وَأَنِ اسْتَغْفِرُوا رَبَّكُمْ ثُمَّ تُوبُوا إِلَيْهِ. Seek forgiveness of your Lord and repent back to him. يُمَتِّعْكُمْ مَتَاعًا حَسَنًا إِلَىٰ أَجَلٍ مُسَمَّى. He will give you a happy life, a pleasant life, a life of comfort.
SubhanAllah.
SubhanAllah. So always with iman, with faith, with belief, and with returning back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you have a life of happiness, a life of comfort, as Allah ta'ala in the Quran promised. وَعَدَ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا مِنْكُمْ وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ لَيُحْيِيَنَّهُمْ حَيَاةً طَيِّبَةً. Allah promised those who believe amongst you and do righteous actions, that Allah ta'ala will cause them, will enable them to live a happy life.
Yeah. So let's get into it, Sheikh.
Inshallah.
Okay, let's get into it. The story that's known, the story of Jonah and the whale. Okay, Yunus alayhi salam. Okay,
yeah,
where did it all begin, Sheikh?
It begins when Yunus alayhi salam. Nineveh is a place where it's a place in Iraq.
Okay.
Yunus alayhi salam was sent to them. They were idolaters. They used to worship idols. Yunus alayhi salam advised them and spent much time with them, advising them, admonishing them, warning them from Allah's punishment if they continue worshipping idols, and reminding them of the fate of the people of Nuh, people of Saleh, people of Ad, people of Lut and all the people before them. But his people rejected Yunus totally. And in fact, furthermore, they said to him, bring the torment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, bring the adab of Allah, the punishment of Allah ta'ala if you are truthful. So Yunus alayhi salam got very upset and very angry, and he left with anger and sorrow.
So he left his people, Shaykh?
He left them because he was angry with them.
Allah.
But what happened with Yunus alayhi salam? He left them without taking Allah's permission.
Okay.
Generally, Allah Ta'ala will give them permission to the prophets to leave. Then they can leave. But Yunus alayhi salam got upset from them, not for himself, not because they rejected him, because they rejected Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So he got upset from them, as Allah Ta'ala in the Quran said, وَذَنُّونِ إِذْ ذَهَبَ مُغَاضِبًا. And the man of the fish, which is Yunus alayhi salam,
yes,
who left in great anger and massive anger, basically. إِذْ ذَهَبَ مُغَاضِبًا فَظَنَّ أَن لَّن نَّقْدِرَ عَلَيْهِ. Then Allah Ta'ala placed him in the belly of the whale.
SubhanAllah.
And while he was, many people who translate this verse, they fall in mistakes. SubhanAllah. They say, فَظَنَّ أَن لَّن نَّقْدِرَ عَلَيْهِ, that he believed or he thought and he had doubt that Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala is unable to overpower him.
Overpower who? Yunus?
Yunus, yeah. That we are not able to defeat him, we're not able to seize him. That is wrong.
Of course.
Okay. There are two words here that people have to understand very well. Dhanna here doesn't mean that Allah Ta'ala that Yunus alayhi salam had doubt. No. Dhanna here means that Yunus was certain. Because in the Quran, dhanna comes with the meaning of being certain. I'll give you another example. In the Quran, Allah Ta'ala said, إني ظننت أني ملاق حسابي. The person in Jannah will say, I was sure, I was certain that I will be accountable in the day of judgment.
Okay.
ظننت here doesn't mean that I was in doubt. It means that I was sure.
Okay.
So Yunus alayhi salam was sure. Sure of what here? أن لن نقدر عليه doesn't mean that Allah Ta'ala is unable to let him go through difficulty or hardship or whatever. It means here that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not make it narrow on him, will not make it difficult on him. It's taken from the qadr, from making things difficult and narrow.
Okay.
As in the Quran, Allah Ta'ala said, وَأَمَّا مَنْ قُدِرَ عَلَيْهِ رِزْقُهُ. As for the person whom Allah Ta'ala made his provision narrow.
Yes.
From qadr, not from qudra, not from ability. It's taken from the making things narrow. You see? So he believed firmly and certainly that Allah Ta'ala will not make things narrow on him and difficult on him, and therefore he made dua. You see? Now it makes sense.
Yes, of course.
وَذَنُّونِ إِذْ ذَهَبَ مُغَاضِبًا فَظَنَّ أَن لَّن نَّقْدِرَ عَلَيْهِ. And the man of the fish, when he went in anger and he believed firmly, or he was certain that Allah Ta'ala will not make things difficult, more difficult on him and more harder on him. فَنَادَى فِي الظُّلُمَاتِ. And he called upon Allah Ta'ala in the darkness. SubhanAllah. Three darkness. Darkness of the night, darkness of the whale, and darkness of the ocean. SubhanAllah. أَنْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا أَنْتَ. Oh Allah, there is no God worthy of worship but you. سبحانك, glory be to you. إني كنت من الظالمين. Indeed, I was from the wrongdoers. What a great dua. Subhanallah. The Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, there is nobody who will say this dua in any calamity or any difficulty. And then he makes this dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala unless Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala relieve him.
Subhanallah. Allahu Akbar.
Subhanallah.
A prophetic promise, Shaykh.
Prophetic promise, subhanAllah ta'ala. No one was to say this dua and was to give the wisdom to utter it at the time of difficulty unless Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala remove his calamity.
SubhanAllah.
La ilaha illallah, but sincere from his heart.
Of course.
Has to be sincere from his heart. Sincere from his heart, subhanAllah. La ilaha illa anta subhanaka inni kuntu min al-zalimin. دعوة أخي ذا النون ما قال أحد ما قالها رجل قط في كرب إلا فرجه الله عنه. The supplication of my brother ذا النون Yunus alayhi salam, no one was saying in a time of difficulty unless Allah Ta'ala relieve him from his difficulty and his hardship.
So Shaykh, how did he end up in the belly of the whale?
Well, subhanAllah, as soon as he left his city, he left in anger, and then he boarded with some people in a small ship. And he was amongst them. They saw him, mashallah ta'ala, engaged in worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, engaged in remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They felt that there's someone who's righteous with them. But subhanAllah ta'ala, while he was on, while they were sailing on the sea, what happened is that a strong storm came nearby, and started shaking the whole ship, subhanAllah ta'ala. And they started throwing their heavy goods so that they can go away from it. But that didn't help at all. And then they had some practice that time. They said, okay, someone amongst us who's not good, then we throw him on the water, then the storm will subside.
Okay. SubhanAllah. Superstition, Shaykh.
Like this, yeah. But it's another mistake that Yunus alayhi salam as well participated in. And that's why Allah Ta'ala in the Quran said, فَسَاهَمْ فَكَمُ مُحَظِينَ فَالْتَقَمَهُ الْحُوتُ وَمُلِيمُ. Meaning he was, when the whale took him or swallowed him, he was blameworthy. Okay? But let's go to the story now, okay? So they draw a lot amongst them.
Okay.
And for the first time, the card of Yunus alayhi salam came out. So he has to be thrown on the water. They said, no, you are a righteous person, let's do it again. We don't want to throw you away. Again, for second time, the card of Yunus alayhi salam came out. They said, let's try it again. For the third time, the card of Yunus alayhi salam came out. Then he knew alayhi salam that Allah Ta'ala wanted him to come out. So he threw himself from the ship into the ocean. As soon as he threw himself to the ship, the whale was nearby as well. He came and swallowed him without harming him. Allah Ta'ala revealed to the whale that you just take him, swallow him, but do not harm him.
SubhanAllah.
Don't break for him any bone. Don't bite any flesh.
SubhanAllah. Okay. Shaykh, we're going to go for a break, inshallah ta'ala. But after the break, we're going to find out how Yusuf alayhi salam was saved from the whale.
Yunus
alayhi salam was saved from the whale, inshallah. Brothers and sisters, I'm so excited that I'm mixing names of prophets, subhanAllah. I hope you're as excited as me at home, inshallah ta'ala. Please stay with us. Straight after the break, we'll find out more about the story of Yunus alayhi salam. Stay with us, inshallah.
Welcome back, brothers and sisters. You've joined us in the middle of the story of Yunus alayhi wasalatu wasalam. When we just finished, we were talking about Yunus alayhi salam, and he was just in the belly of the whale, subhanAllah. So now, what we're going to do, inshallah, it's that time of the show where we go out to the street and we talk to the people to find out how much they know about these topics. So today's question, we asked, what was the reason that saved the Prophet Yunus or Jonah from the belly of the whale? Let's find out what happened.
The Prophet Yunus alayhi salam was saved from the belly of the whale when he repented to Allah and he said, La ilaha illa anta, subhanaka inni kuntu min al-zalimin.
He cried out from there, La ilaha illa anta subhanak inni kuntu min al-zalimin. It includes two things. First, his admission of his mistake, and secondly, the glory of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he said that I was wrongdoer, but you, glory be to you, and that the thing which saved him. Allah said that if he had not said that thing, he would have remained there forever.
There you have it. We have some quite confident answers there.
Inshallah.
So over to you, Sheikh, alhamdulillah, for clarification.
They were very close, mashallah.
Mashallah.
Not very precise, but very close, mashallah ta'ala. Allah ta'ala in the Quran mentioned that he made this dua, and Allah ta'ala saved him. However, Allah ta'ala also mentioned the main reason of saving Yunus alayhi salam. That reason is because Yunus alayhi salam used to be before falling in the belly of the whale, he used to be from those who profusely glorify Allah Ta'ala.
SubhanAllah.
He used to engage in the glorification of Allah Ta'ala a lot. And that's why Allah Ta'ala saved him. Allah Ta'ala in the Quran said, فلولا أنه كان من المسبحين. Haven't he was amongst those who used to glorify Allah Ta'ala constantly. للبث في بطنه إلى يوم يبعثون. He would have stayed inside his belly until the day when they are resurrected. SubhanAllah. You see?
Until the day of judgment, yeah.
Until the day of judgment.
La ilaha.
You know that the bodies of the prophets, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is forbidden upon the earth to eat them. So he will stay on his belly until the day of judgment.
Allahu Akbar, Shaykh. SubhanAllah. Shaykh, how did he survive in there?
Well, Allah ta'ala in the Quran mentioned this story saying that فنادى في الظلمات أن لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إني كنت من الظالمين. Then Allah Ta'ala said, look at this verse. What a wonderful verse. What an encouraging verse to all of us. That when we are in difficulty, that we ask Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala. Allah Ta'ala said, فاستجبنا له فنجيناه من الغم. And we responded to him. And we saved him from the calamity. Severe calamity, from
Allah.
Severe stress. SubhanAllah.
Allahu
وكذلك نوجي المؤمنين. And this is how we save the believers. When they are in a very difficult moment, when they are in very difficult calamity, Allah Ta'ala save them. Likewise, all the prophets, Allah Ta'ala, the Quran said, حتى إذا استيأس الرسل. And once the rusul, the prophets, feel that they lost hope. خلاص. وظنوا أنهم قد كذبوا. And they feel that they have been belied. خلاص. جاءهم نصرنا. Our victory will come to them. فنجي من نشاء. And they will save whomever we want. ولا يرد بأسنا عن القوم المجرمين. And our punishment will not be returned and will actually hit the wrongdoers. Now back to the story.
Yes, Sheikh.
Allah Ta'ala said, فَالْتَقَمَهُ الْحُوتُ وَهُوَ مُلِيمٌ. Then the whale swallowed him and he was blameworthy because he engaged in the lot draw.
Oh yes.
SubhanAllah. Or lottery draw, call it. Then Allah Ta'ala said, فَنَبَذْنَاهُ بِالْعَرَاءِ وَهُوَ سَقِيمٌ. Then once he made the dua, Allah Ta'ala responded to him, the whale threw him in the wide open land.
SubhanAllah.
SubhanAllah. And then Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala allowed a tree to be, as Allah Ta'ala enabled, or Allah Ta'ala grew a tree for nearby him. SubhanAllah. But when he was thrown, he was as well ill from the acid of the belly of the
whale.
The whale, SubhanAllah. Allah Ta'ala, the Quran said, فَنَبَذْنَاهُ بِالْعَرَاءِ وَهُوَ سَقِيمٌ.
Oh, yes.
Okay, when he's ill, when he's suffering from illness, he was thrown on that wide open land. وَأَنْبَتْنَا عَلَيْهِ شَجَرَةً مِّن يَقْطِينٍ. And we grew for him a tree of yaqtin. Good vine from يقطين. نعم. And then Allah Ta'ala said, وَأَرْسَلْنَاهُ إِلَى مِئَةِ أَلْفٍ أَوْ يَزِيدُونَ. Then we sent him into 100,000 people.
So Allah mentioned the number, Shaykh.
The number, yeah. Or more than them.
Allahu Akbar.
فَآمَنُوا فَمَتَّعْنَاهُمْ إِلَى حِينَ. And they believed, and Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala gave them bounty until for a while.
Sheikh, these were the same people?
The same people. But what happened to SubhanAllah, when he left them, very, very strange story. He left them and Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala was about to punish them. But Yunus alayhi salam left in anger and he left without Allah's permission. You see here? As soon as Yunus alayhi salam left them, the color of the sky changed. As if the sky will throw fire on them. And they got very scared, very terrified, very shocked, SubhanAllah Ta'ala. And they saw a storm nearby. So straight away the iman, the faith penetrated in their heart. and they believed in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they remembered the destiny and the fate of the people of Nuh, people of Hud, people of Saleh, and straight away they repented to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How did they do that? They, all of them, took their family, their children, they climbed the mountains. And they started making dua and calling upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And they repented to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and crying out.
SubhanAllah.
Crying out for a long time. Because they see the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Both of them. They start crying and weeping until their cry was echoed by the mountains around them. SubhanAllah. The whole area was crying.
Allahu Akbar. Amazing.
Because of Allah's punishment is nearby, subhanAllah.
Allahu Akbar.
Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepted their repentance. And Allah ta'ala removed the punishment from them. And when Yunus alayhi salam returned back to them, he found them believing.
SubhanAllah.
He must have been so happy.
It was a very good ending.
Alhamdulillah.
If only the people of Thamud did the same, subhanAllah.
Allah musta'an. Allah musta'an. All of them, Allah ta'ala in the Quran mentioned that. That if they have if they repented to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, returned back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, had given them a nice life, happy life.
Shaykh, what was it that the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said about Yunus alayhi wa sallatu wa sallam?
Because Yunus alayhi wa sallam left without seeking Allah's permission, people might speak about him saying why he disobeyed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Okay, sure.
And he as well participated in the drawing of the lot.
Yes.
They might say why he did that, he's a prophet as well.
Yeah.
Okay.
And that's why Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, no one is allowed to say that I, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, am better than Yunus bin Matta. Okay. No one should say that.
SubhanAllah.
No one should say that I am or Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is better than Yunus bin Matta.
Okay, just to kind of as a preserving the integrity of Yunus alayhi salam.
Preserving his status.
Yes.
And his position in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yeah.
MashaAllah. And I think Yunus, the story of Yunus has taught us this immense dua that you mentioned, Shaykh.
Allahu Akbar.
Please, for those brothers and sisters who may have just joined us, what was the dua of Yunus, Shaykh?
Well, the dua of Yunus, let me tell you a story about the dua of Yunus.
Okay.
And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, on occasion, he went out and he found the companions with him. And he said to them, shall I give you a dua? If you say it in any time of difficulty, whenever you encounter a hardship or difficulty, you say this dua, Allah Ta'ala will remove your calamity. While he was saying that, somebody called him for to answer his need. So he left the Sahaba and went. And amongst the Sahaba was Sa'd ibn Waqqas. Okay? And he was shocked that he wanted to know the hadith. And Abdurrahman bin Awfa as well, likewise. Full of companions. They were there, they couldn't hear the hadith. So they missed out, subhanAllah. But what happened after a while, at the time of Umar radiallahu anhu, in one occasion he said, Sa'ad radiallahu anhu said, every time I remember the hadith, and this occasion, I forget everything around me. And I don't feel that anyone is around me. I just become overwhelmed with this thought. What is a dua? As I missed something very great. So in one occasion, Abdurrahman bin Auf passed by Sa'd ibn Waqqas, the time of Umar radiallahu anhu, And Abdurrahman said, Salaamu alaykum. Sa'd didn't reply and left. He looked at him like this. He filled his eye with his looking at him. Then he left. Abdurrahman got upset. He went to Umar complaining, what happened with my brother? My brother Sa'd, I love him so much. He's not replying salam to me. And he looked at me. Umar said, he didn't look at you. He said, no, he looked at my face and filled his eyes with my face, subhanAllah. But then he left without saying salam to me, without replying to me. They called Sa'd. Abdurrahman was there and Sa'd was there. Umar asked him, why did you not reply to your brother's salam? He said, I didn't see him. Abdurrahman said, wallahi, by Allah, I saw him, he saw me and he looked at me. Sa'd said, subhanAllah, if that happened, then it might be at the time when I remember something about the Prophet of Allah, the story when Rasulullah said to us that there is a dua of my brother, the Noon, whoever said it, Allah Ta'ala will relieve him from any calamity that he's encountering.
SubhanAllah.
You see?
SubhanAllah, Allah brought
you. Abdurrahman said, I was there as well. And then when I saw the Prophet going to his home, I went behind him. I asked him about the dua. And the Rasulullah told me about the dua. And the dua is to say, Subhanaka la ilaha illa ant, inni kuntu min al-zalimin. La ilaha illa ant, subhanaka inni kuntu min al-zalimin.
لا إله إلا أنت
سبحانك إني كنت من الظالمين
إني كنت من الظالمين
لا إله إلا there is no god worthy of worship O Allah but you glory be to you I was amongst the wrongdoers
ما شاء الله
you say it in any calamity when you encounter any difficulty Allah Ta'ala will relieve you from it as long as you say it sincerely to Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala
so if this is the only thing we take away from the story of Yunus It is enough for us, subhanAllah.
Sufficient, subhanAllah.
Allah is sufficient for us.
SubhanAllah.
Our time has ended, subhanAllah, Shaykh.
Always a sad time, alhamdulillah. But an opportunity has come for us to take some benefit. Go and memorize the dua, inshaAllah. And inshaAllah, Allah might allow us to utilize it at a beneficial time when a calamity strikes us. But until next time, brothers and sisters, JazakAllah khair from our beloved Shaykh, from us both here.
JazakAllah.
And Allah bless you all. We will continue next time with the lives of the prophets. Until then. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله
لقد كان في قصصهم عبرة لأولي الألباب ما كان حديثا يفترى ولكن تصديق الذي بين يديه وتفصيل كل شيء وهدى ورحمة لقوم يؤمنون